Hello, I'm Ashley Tepazon here at Murphy Spring Wetland in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Today we're going to talk about the functions and importance of our magnificent wetland. Let's begin with Christina, who will tell us what a wetland is.
Hi, I'm Christina Calhoun, and I'm here to tell you about wetlands. Wetlands are areas that are covered with water long enough to support plant life that thrive in wet soil. Wetlands occur in any state, including here, Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Wetlands can go on for miles or be as small as ponds, depending on soil, vegetation, and climate.
Many people say that wetlands act as natural sponge and filters. They help to absorb and slow down water, while at the same time catching erosion sediments. When we have heavy rains, wetlands do an awesome job of reducing floods by absorbing water and allowing it to soak into the ground, recharging the groundwater in that area. In many towns and cities where wetlands have been removed, we see increased problems with flooding. As for filtering, the plants and natural bacteria that live in a wetland can actually pull toxic substances out of the water, leaving the water much cleaner than before. So that we know, wetlands can absorb and store water while filtering it, resulting in cleaner water when it leaves the wetlands. But wetlands are also a source of wood and food for many people. Most of the trees found in this wetland can be used for furniture, cabinet making, flooring, lumber, and even medical uses. The bark of the black willow can be used to reduce pain, swellings, headaches, and tree cuts and bruises. For hundreds of years, the bark of the slippery elm tree has been used for sore throats, indigestion, and stomach ulcers, as well as wounds, burns, and scalds. Wetlands perform all these duties to help keep our environment healthy, but maybe most importantly, they provide valuable habitats for plants and animals.
Even though we are in the middle of a city, we can find an enormous variety of wildlife in the wetland. When you look closely, you can find many different types of birds, mammals, reptiles, amphibians, fish, and invertebrates.
The Murphy Spring Wetland has a lot of different animals, such as wood ducks, mallard ducks, herons, such as the great blue heron, muskrat, northern water snake, garter snake, red-eared sliders, southern leopard frog, zigzag salamander, mosquito fish, long-eared sunfish, dragonflies, damselflies, snails, and crayfish.
All of them are able to live here only because of this wonderful wetland.
This is a palustrine wetland. Palustrine wetlands have very dense covers of trees, shrubs, or emerging plants. This wetland includes wet meadows or shallow ponds. They provide cover and forage for wildlife traveling between upland and aquatic habitats. Palustrine wetlands include all inland wetlands except those along lakeshores and rivers. Generally, they are small in size and shallow. They may be connected by surface or groundwater to rivers or lakes, or they may be isolated.
Not all wetlands have many trees, but here we can find black willow, green ash, sycamore, cottonwood, slippery elm, and red maple. Some of the emergent aquatic plants in Murphy Spring Wetland include duck potato, a type of arrowhead, pickerel weed, duckweed, lizard tail, and cattail.
Despite their many values, wetlands have been misunderstood throughout the years and abused because their importance was not obvious. For many years, wetlands were seen as useless swamps. They were drained, filled in, polluted, and used as dumps. Destruction nationwide has been dramatic. Over half of the United States have been lost since the 1700s. Today, threats include development, natural degradation, pollution, filling, agriculture, and invasive plants. For example, this area no longer has any open water. In the past 7 years, purple loosestrife has grown. From a few plants with open water to what we see now, ducks and geese can no longer live in this part of the wetland.
Wetlands are most of the biologically productive habitats on Earth. That means they provide enough energy to support huge numbers of plants and animals, similar to rainforests and coral reefs. And just like the rainforests, wetlands are in trouble. In the United States of America alone, we have lost over 117 million acres of wetland. That's an area roughly the size of California, Massachusetts, and Vermont combined. Most of our recent losses over the past 20 years have been due to agriculture and urban development, as well as pollution. Now that we know how helpful and important wetlands are, we need to do everything we can to protect what little we have left.
Thank you for watching the news on wetlands here at Murfreesboro Discovery Center.
Thank you! Woo!